Hello people, my name is Ferdy, and in this video I'll show you how you can create a website mockup like this, or like this, or like this, or like this, or like this. Let me show you how. The first thing I want to do, I want to show you why you want to use that. Well, if you have a website and you want to showcase the amazing websites you have created for other people, you want to showcase it in a beautiful way. So if I go to the website somedia.nl, for instance, it's a web design agency in the Netherlands. I go to the portfolio, I see a mockup like this, and that's something we're going to create. Oh, by the way, for this tutorial, you need Photoshop. We're going to use Photoshop in this tutorial. So let me show you how. The first thing I want to do, I want to use Google Chrome because I want to use a Google Chrome extension, a free extension that will help you to create images of any website. So if you go to ferdy.com/, let's see, go full page. Hit enter, you go to the Chrome extension, go full page, and that will help you to create a complete image of a website. So I installed it, and now if I go to ferdy.com, that's the website I want to use. I can scroll down a bit because there can be some incoming animations. I want to take those with me in my full page screenshot. Then I go to this icon over here. It's called go full page. I click on it and look at this. A screenshot of my complete website will be made. Before, I had to do it manually, stitch things together in Photoshop. Now it's working better. So I click on download over here, and I will download it as a PNG. If I open it, I open it in Photoshop, and there you go, high quality. Awesome, this is what we're gonna use later. So I go back. Now I want to go to my website again. I want to make it a bit smaller. Now I want to have a version that is for a tablet, like this. Well, to be honest, I don't like this. I should fix that. Okay. So let's do this one. Again, I click over here. So that's image two. I click on download. And then there's the third one, even smaller. And I need to click on this icon, and I click on go full page, and there it goes. Now it takes a picture of my website as a mobile, viewed on a mobile. Awesome. I make it bigger again, and I click on download. And now I want to download a file. We're going to make use of a file from ThemeForest. It will cost $8. So I go to ferdy.com/mockup, hit enter. Now we'll be redirected to the right image. At once, or the right the file. It's $8. I already bought it, it says over here. And there are a few examples. This is how you can display things. So I like this one. And what I like about this one is that it uses the latest iPhones. There are some others, but they still use iPads from 1953. So I prefer to use something that's up to date. I found this one, $8. Before they were $30, so I think it's a good deal. I can click on buy now if you are not a member yet over here. Need to fill in your details. If you have done so, you can click on pay with PayPal. I will go back because I already downloaded it. So I click on download it here. And there it goes. It can be quite a big file. It's 820 megabytes. So we're going to have a break. How are you doing? What's been going on in your life? You know, even though I can hear it, maybe it's good to speak it out. Sometimes it's not about the person hearing it. It's about you talking about it. That gives the relief. The best thing is if there's someone that can listen to you. But it's a great start to start talking, even though there's nobody around. I wish my internet connection was faster because I'm like, what should I do now? What should I do? I don't know what to say to you. Hey, I can edit this. So I will be back with you in a second, and then it's downloaded. Let me stretch out a little bit. This video is not sponsored by anyone. Let's continue. Okay, there it is. I open it and I really like this. It's the fun part. If it's not fun up until this part, then right now I hope it will be. Okay, I go to the main file. I can hit space and I can see the versions there are. This one, this one. I like this one. Ooh, even better. Less space. Okay. I go for fell 4. That's how many children I would like to have. Okay. I can get rid of the background, but we're going to talk about it later. So over here, I see my design here. Phone, tablet, laptop, and iMac. I double click on the lowest one. Then I open a new Photoshop file. And now I go to my downloads and I grab the big website file. This one, I can zoom in with Command Plus or with Option. And then I scroll on my mouse. I scroll up. I select this part, Command or Control C. Then I go to layer 1. I paste it. Then I go to Edit, Transform, Scale. Then I say Command 0. So I see an overview of everything that's in my screen. And I start dragging over here, holding Shift so I maintain my aspect ratio. And I think this is great. Then I want to bring it to the center. So let me zoom in a bit until I see that purple line. Now it's in the center. Hit Enter. I say Command or Control S. And when I do that, look at this. Voila! Beautiful. Then I want to go for the laptop. I paste the same image again. Command 0. Sorry, Edit, Transform, Scale. Now Command 0. Now I drag this to the center. See if I can make it as wide as possible. I bring it to the center again. I think this is not beautiful. So maybe a little bit more. If you hold Option and Shift, then it scales to the center. Okay, so let's keep the numbers here and then bring this to the center. Okay, I save it. That's the second one. Then the tablet version. Let me see. This one. Open it. Copy. Paste. Edit. Transform. Scale. Command 0. Drag it up. Okay. Command S. There it goes. And then the latest one, the phone. Double click and it opens in Photoshop for me. Copy this. Command W, paste it. Edit, transform, scale, Command 0. Hold Shift, zoom in, bring it to the center. Perfektenschlag. Close it. Now it looks like this. There is a fog over it. I don't know if you know what I mean, but it's not as vibrant as over here. So I want that. So how can I fix it? I just start playing around with background stuff. Noise. I got rid of the noise. Okay. I'm still not completely happy. So I go to the iMac. I get rid of the adjustments. I go to the laptop. Get rid of the adjustments. I go to the tablet. I get rid of the adjustments. I go to the phone and I get rid of the adjustments. Okay. What I will do, I will create a selection like this. Make sure that the shadow is included over here. If I want to subtract from the selection, I hold Option. Go a bit lower because there's no shadow over here. And then I say image, corrupt. Okay. Then I say file, export, save for web, legacy. I change the width. It's taking a while because I'm recording and it's a really big high resolution file. So let me see how big it is. It's 4,000 pixels. I'm still not completely happy with how it looks. There's more contrast over here. So let's see what's happening. If I export this, how it will look. 1280, that's the width for me. That's perfect. PNG is what I want because of the transparent background. I click on save. And I call this one Ferdy.com. And then the name of my company, Web Design Amsterdam. So I can be found on when people search for, or I say Web Design Amsterdam. So people, when people search for Web Design Amsterdam, this image can pop up and they think, whoa, that website is amazing with a beautiful guy in the picture. Wow. And then they go to my website. So desktop, save. Okay, let's see how it looks. Desktop. Yeah, the contrast is back. So this is what I like. And I can use this if I want to. Finishing touch, I go to tinypng.com. Drop my image here. So I go to the desktop. It's 577 kilobytes. I want to make it smaller. So I do that with tinypng. It's a lot smaller now, 142. And now if I would go to wearewebdesign.com and I log in, I edit this with Elementor. And I want to go over here to style, choose a background image, upload files, and I go to the downloads. I select it. Look at this. The background is still there. By the way, if you're not happy with the contrast, I'm not happy with it. What you can do, you can click on the upper layer, this one. Then you click on levels, so adjustments. So you can go to window, adjustments, click on levels. And I see over here, there's a gap. So this gap makes it less contrasty. That's a weird word. So I drag this to the left and what you will see, the contrast will come back a bit and then you can slide the middle one to the right in order to make it pop a little bit more. So this is what I prefer. So that's how you can create something like this. I'm happy with the result and I can do this for any website I create and in that way create a really beautiful portfolio mockup. So thank you for watching this tutorial. Feel free to subscribe for more upcoming WordPress related tutorials and please like this video. And if you have any questions, leave a comment and I will do my best to answer you. Okay, ciao.